Welcome to the video news of the week. Early last Friday morning, a fire at the corner of Diamond Pond Road and East Colebrook Road destroyed a shed and nearby pickup truck before moving to the end of a mobile home where the two residents, Robert and Patrick McGinn, were sleeping. Their neighbor, firefighter Arthur Boscheman, went directly to the scene as soon as the fire was called out and was able to awaken the McGinns. It is believed that the fire was electrical in nature and started in a separate shed, which was in back of the mobile home. Thursday at around noon, there was a motor vehicle accident in front of the first Clarksville store on Route 3 in Clarksville. The Chronicle was at the scene where it appeared that the accident involved a motorcycle and a pickup truck. The driver of the motorcycle was ultimately transported to Dartmouth-Hitchcock Medical Center with serious injuries. New Hampshire State Police are investigating the accident. The Northumberland Selectmen heard over 2 hours of testimony from around 60 members of the public who had come to their meeting on Tuesday night. The topic was the board's recent closing of Page Hill Road to ATV traffic, a key connection between Lancaster and Groveton for ATV riders. One of the residents who spoke was Brian Connors, who faced the ATV riders with his complaints and described for them the loss of his horse after several ATVs had spooked her.
I went down to Lancaster. I used to take my horse on Friday down to Lancaster to get my groceries and come back, horse and buggy, right? No problem. One Friday afternoon, 7 four-wheelers circled my buggy and my horse. She went up over a rock wall, came down over the top of the buggy, landed on me, got hurt, stowed the buggy all to pieces, dragged me 20, 30 yards down the road. My damage is my horse, which is now dead. Nobody gives a damn about I paid for it out of my pocket. I lost a lot with that horse. She was 4.5 years old, right? To me, the state of New Hampshire has taken four-wheelers and given them the right to ride on the road, but they haven't educated people. They haven't said, do this, do that, get the four-wheeler trails clubs together, get the businesses in Lancaster and say, let's train everybody. Let's make this safe. What's the speed limit on Page Hill Road for 10? It is 10 miles an hour. It's posted at both ends of the road.
This North Country's economy shot to pieces, as you should know. You just look out the window here. And this ATV thing is a big, very big thing to happen. It's like probably opening up a couple of factories for business, you know, for income. And I see a really big difference with the ATVs coming in. You can't rely on snowmobiling because the climate's kind of changing with the snow. But ATVs are a longer season. It's probably one of the best things that's happened to the area.
In the end, the selectmen voted to reopen Page Hill Road for a one-year trial on the basis that ATV clubs would step up patrols and report to the selectmen monthly.
Jim, second by Jim. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed?
No.
2-1. She's back.
Last weekend marked Memorial Day in the North Country. The Colebrook Parade came marching through downtown in the midst of pouring rain.
Good job, guys!
Stratford held its ceremony on Friday, led by students of the local school.
Memorial Day honors the men and women of the American Army, Navy, Coast Guard, Air Force, and Marines.
Amen. Also on Monday morning were events in Pittsburgh, Beecher Falls, and Canaan.
eternal blessing rest upon those they left behind. Keep us forever firm in righteousness, humble of heart, and in selflessness of purpose. Amen.
The Groveton Elementary School held its spring concert last Wednesday evening as the school year winds to a close.
Here comes the rain, it's pouring, and the sun is light. The flowers blossom and the butterflies say goodbye. Take me out to the ball game, take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if I ever get back. For the caps like it up, get it flaps like it up. Guess what? Wah! It's probably it up.
At the end, the students thanked new music instructor Catherine Carter and wished her well on her future years at the school.
Ms. Carter, we would like to give these to you, and we thank you very much. We hope you will enjoy the rest of your time, even though we're leaving you.
The Riverside Wolves are a new football team that has recently been formed in the North Country. The team consists of players from Groveton and Pittsburgh and include Canaan, Norton, and Lemington. The team has been practicing at the Rippling Brook Campground in Columbia to ready themselves for the August season.
Get your feet moving, Jason! Square up!
I want to see how you're looking down the line. Everybody lining up on the ball?
Hey, oh,
there you go.
Okay, guys.
Okay, let's go through it. Everybody ready? Offensive line, you know how you measure? Get your gaps.
Whoa.
Homemade steam engines and drag saws were among the many things to be heard at the Cookshire Fairgrounds during last Sunday's Crank Day. The event is held every year by the Eastern Township's Antique Machinery Club, where collectors of old motors and other antiques get together for a day of showing off their treasures. Congregations gathered at the Trinity United Church in Cookshire for a day of hymns. The Gospels were sung in memory of loved ones that have passed away over the years in the special event held last Sunday morning. While roaming around Sherbrooke, Quebec, our Canadian correspondent Corey Bellum came across local brass ensemble Groovin' Brass. The members are all from the Lennoxville and Sherbrooke area, and it wasn't long until they had over 100 people gathered around listening to their sounds. The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by the Upper Connecticut Valley Hospital in Colebrook. Visit their website at ucvh.org. Compassionate healthcare close to home. LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Colebrook Plumbing and Heating in Colebrook. Why heat with oil when you can heat economically with wood? Come see our whole house wood boiler solutions currently on sale. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. More rain on the horizon for the coming weekend. Friday brings a high of 57 and a low of 40. Saturday clears up a bit with a high of 68. And Sunday sees more rain showers with a high of 67 and a low of 50 degrees. The Pittsburg-Canaan Yellow Jackets played host to the Colebrook Mohawks in softball and baseball action this past week.
Hey, let's go, Bree, let's go, Bree.
Way to go, Bree. Way to
go, Bree.
Come on,
Leg, you got it?
Come on, come on,
come on.
Hey, you're up,
Bree.
Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.